Are there any alternatives?
Well, for steroids?
Yeah, well, I mean, to something to combat the cedar fever, it's just basically pollen in your eyes and nose and throat.
I heard about it in Austin. I heard about that. It's pretty bad, and you know, there are allergic reactions that occur. The best thing you can do for allergic reactions, believe it or not, is the exact opposite of what the doctors in the medical model will do, and that's build your immune system, strengthen your immune system. When you have cedar allergy or any kind of allergy, what you're having is an immune system response. That means a defensive response. Your body's trying to protect you. So all those the signs of allergies, like watery eyes and a runny nose and a stuffy head, all of those are signs that fluid is beginning to leak inside your head in response to this attack from the cedar pollen. So you say, what's up with fluid and mucus and runny nose and congested head? Why would that be? Why, Tony, let me ask you something. You're a lay person, I take it. You're not a medical professional. What do you think? Why would the body respond to some kind of allergen or some kind of attack on the body? Why would the body's response be fluidization, the secretion of fluids and mucus? What do you suppose the reason for that is? Is it an accident? Is it a mistake? Did God make a mistake? Did the divine force make a mistake? Or do you think there's a purpose for it? And if you do, Woody, I'm going to turn the tables here and ask you a question. What do you think the purpose would be?
Well, the way I understand it, it's not a weak immune system. It's basically an overstimulation of the immune system. The immune system is overreacting to whatever it is, whether it's ragweed or in this case, cedar.
That's not what I'm asking you. In your opinion, and I'm just curious to know what you as a layperson think, in your opinion, or based on what your ideas about how the body works, why is the response fluidization, the secretion of fluids? Why would that be the response? Why wouldn't it be a drying up, for example?
Maybe I'm dehydrated?
No. The fluidization in response to an allergic attack is one of the ways the body flushes things out. So when you tear, the body is trying to flush things out of the eyes, of the eye area. When your blood vessels inside your head open up, your body's trying to flush things out of your sinus cavities, the inner channels in your head. When you have mucus secretion, your body is trying to protect itself by secreting a protective layer between the allergen and tissues in the body. So what we experience as unpleasantries, what we experience as discomfort, are really the signs of the body's way of protecting itself. We don't want to suppress that, ever. The dumbest thing that a doctor or the medical model could ever do, I don't want to say doctors, we'll call it the medical model, is suppress this activity. It's the body's protective mechanism. What you want to do is you want to boost the immune system, strengthen the immune system, and probably the most important, there's a couple ways to do it, but in my opinion, the number one thing to do is to reduce what's called the load on the immune system. Think of the immune system as a dump truck, and it has a certain amount of capacity. The dump truck has a certain load capacity. And so when the immune system is working on, for example, problem foods, or it's working on bacteria or toxins, when the immune system is protecting us from, say, poisons inside our house, maybe from our copying machine or maybe from insulation, and then all of a sudden it has another load that it has to work on, say pollen from cedar, it becomes overloaded. And so one of the most important strategies for dealing with cedar pollen or any seasonal pollen is to reduce the load on the digestive system, the other work it has to do. You can't stop the pollen. You can't stop the cedar. But if you have other immune loads, if you have other things that you're doing that are overloading the immune system, those things you do have control over. So first and foremost, the largest component by far of the immune system is the digestive system. And as weird as it sounds, the best thing you could do is protect your digestive system from, or support the immune system in the digestive tract. And that means using probiotics especially. In fact, that's my number one digestive supplement for dealing with these seasonal allergies, is a good probiotic supplement like the Biolumin Nightly Essence. That's number one. Secondly, vitamin C is probably the most important of the immune vitamins. I would be doing high doses of vitamin C, anywhere from 1,000 to 5,000 milligrams a day. Don't do it too quick. You never want to drink your vitamin C too quickly, because you could end up with some bloating or gas or diarrhea or some digestive problems as you get a big hit of vitamin C. So kind of sip on the vitamin C, and of course you'll get a bunch of vitamin C in the Beyond Tangy Tangerine product. There's other very, very important immune system boosting nutrients. Vitamin A is really important. In fact, zinc and vitamin A work together to help boost immunity, maybe 50 milligrams of zinc picolinate a day and 20,000 international units of vitamin A a day. Don't forget about magnesium, really, really important for the immune system. And I'd be using anywhere from 1,000 to 2,000 milligrams of magnesium a day. You'll find some magnesium in the OsteoMag product from Youngevity and the Ultimate Daily from Youngevity as well. So first and foremost, and last but not least, is make sure you're drinking a lot of fluids. That can also help flush toxins out of the body and flush allergens out of the body as well. Worst comes to worst, Benadryl is way, way, way gentler than cortisone or prednisone, steroids that you get from the doctor's office. I would never, ever, 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 I don't know how many times I could say it, but if I could say it all, the whole hour, I would say it the whole hour. Never, ever, ever use a steroid drug that I got from a doctor unless I had a life-threatening situation. I cannot say that with enough emphasis. They are among the most toxic, awful, horrible drugs. And one of the first things we learn in pharmacy school is nobody should ever stay on a steroid drug for any length of time unless you have some kind of, you want to use it for some kind of emergency, but you don't want to stay on a steroid drug for a long period of time. Now, I'm not saying that you'd be doing that, but a lot of folks are. A lot of folks who have immune diseases are just on prednisone for years, and it's an awful, awful drug. One of the most pro-aging, breakdown-inducing, wrinkle-causing, immune system-suppressing drugs ever, and yet you still have medical professionals who feel like they can dispense it as if it was just aspirin or an antihistamine. Use Benadryl if you want to use a prescription drug. Focus on the digestive system. Use vitamin C, zinc, vitamin A, and magnesium as well. Make sure you're drinking lots of fluids. Thanks so much for your call, Tony. Appreciate it, and I hope I helped you out. All right, we're going to come back with more of your phone calls. I'm Pharmacist Ben. You're listening to The Bright Side on the Genesis Communication Network. We'll be back after this.
Pharmacist Ben Fuchs knows the importance of proper digestion.
Make sure you take a look at the Ultimate Enzyme product. They're made with bile salts and fat digestion enzymes and protein digestive enzymes. And not only do the Ultimate Enzymes give you obvious benefits for digestion, but they can also help keep your blood flowing through your circulatory system. As most of you probably know by now, thick, sludgy, clotting blood is a serious risk factor for heart disease and stroke. Clearly, inappropriate and excessive blood clotting is a major health issue, and thick, sludgy blood is not just about heart health either. Sludgy blood can compromise oxygenation and nutrient delivery to all your cells and tissues and organs, and ultimately lead to almost any health issue you can name.
Concerned about proper digestion and heart health, order Ultimate Enzymes by calling 866-735-2470. That's 866-735-2470 or on the web at brightsidemen.com. That's brightsidemen.com. Order today.
So we decided to upgrade the look of our home.
You know, improve the curb appeal.
We decided to add the look of stone to the exterior.
We really like the stacked stone look.
Yeah, but when I checked into the price, it was ridiculous. No way could we afford it.
Then a friend told me about Genstone. G-E-N-S-T-O-N-E.
Genstone comes in lightweight panels made of polyurethane. They've actually engineered the hassle out of installation. No mortar, no mesh. It was easy. Even I could do it.
We just screwed the panels to the wall and it looks like stone. I mean, it really looks like stone.
Yeah, from the box to the wall in minutes.
We love the look of our home now.
And Genstone is durable, comes with a 25-year warranty, and offers additional R-value for insulation.
If you want the look of stone at a price you can afford, call Genstone.
At 855-955-STONE. Trust me, you'll save money.
And you'll love the look.
855-955-STONE. That's 855-955-7866.
Do you owe the IRS money that you can't pay? Are tax liens and levies ruining your life? Are you tired of being afraid just to go to the mailbox? If this describes you, then Dan Pilla can help.
Hi, I'm Dan Pilla, and I've been solving tax problems for more than 30 years. In fact, I wrote the book that made it possible to negotiate settlements with the IRS, and I've helped thousands of people do exactly that. Call now at 800-346-6829 to learn how I can help you. You know your IRS debt will not go away by itself, but you don't have to live in fear anymore. New changes to IRS policies will help more people than ever before eliminate their debts once and for all. There's no need for you to suffer another day with IRS debt. Call 800-346-6829. I can help you eliminate wage and bank levies, release tax liens, and negotiate a settlement with the IRS that will put your tax nightmare behind you forever. Call 800-34-NO-TAX or go to my website, taxhelponline.com. That's taxhelponline.com.
Would you like being an insider? Would you like getting exclusive access to prizes and better deals? Would you like some help in making sure you and your loved ones are prepared for the next disaster or emergency? If you answered yes to any of these, here's your simple solution. Join Freeze Dry Guy's Survival Insider Club. Not only is your membership free, you get $10 in survival bucks just for signing up. Then you save at least 10% on purchases, plus enjoy insider access to specials, prizes, and other exclusive offers. Since 1970, veteran-owned Freeze Dry Guy has been your trusted source for long-lasting, easy-to-make freeze-dried food and dehydrated food, perfect for emergency preparedness, RV travel, and outdoor needs from camping to sailing. Enjoy life as a survival insider. Call Freeze Dry Guy now at 866-404-3663, 866-404-FOOD, or log on to freezedryguy.com. That's freezedryguy.com.
The bad boy of broadcasting, Man Cow, has found a new home. The Genesis Communications Network, GCN.
All right, we're back on the Bright Side. I am Pharmacist Ben, and let's go out to, well, let's stay in Texas, talk to David. What's up, David? How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing well. How are you? Thank you.
I'm well. Are you in Austin by any chance? You listening in Austin?
Yes, I am.
Hope we get to see you. You going to come down and see me at Brave New Books on Thursday?
Absolutely.
Good deal. Make sure you say hello.
All right.
What's going on?
The reason I'm contacting is that my son, he has a problem with warts on his hands.
Okay.
How old is your son? 21 now.
Okay.
It started when he was about 15.
Okay. Here's the deal. He doesn't just have warts on his hand, and that's what your job or his job, really his job, is going to be to find other symptoms that he can address. Now, you can take care of the warts by zapping them. You can use colloidal silver. There's a lot of things you can do to take care of the warts. But you want to figure out, why is the immune system not taking care of its business? Why is your immune system or your son's immune system not doing its job? And you'll find more than likely it's overloaded, as we were talking with our last caller. So this idea of load is so important. When the immune system is overloaded, things like warts and allergy symptoms will show up. Warts are caused by a virus. That virus is always around, but not everybody gets warts. He'll only get warts when his immune system is suppressed or overloaded or weakened in some fashion. That means, number one, all warts are like a good thing in a way. They're like a barometer. They're like a window into the immune system, and you can actually see what's happening. So once you take care of the warts, you'll know that you've taken care of the immune system. You've boosted the immune system. So first and foremost, the bulk of the immune system, while there's some immune cells in the skin, obviously, the bulk of the immune system is in the digestive tract. And as we were talking with Tony earlier, you got to focus on the digestive system whenever there is any immune response, whether it's warts or whether it's a runny nose or whether it's any kind of inflammation, whatever. If you got an immune response, the bulk of your immune system is in the digestive tract. Focus there. Now, you'll probably find that he knows he's got some kind of digestive thing going on, bloating or gas or something along those lines. Focus on problem foods and then eliminate those foods. Probiotics are a must-have. Fermented foods and probiotics are must-have for all immune issues because of the digestive connection, for all digestive issues too. That goes without saying. Get on the Biolumin Nightly.
Acidophilus
and such. I like the Biolumin Nightly Essence because it's a well-rounded probiotic. But in addition to the Biolumin Nightly Essence, make sure he's using kefir and miso and tempeh and kimchi and fermented beets and whatever kind of fermented foods he can get to upregulate his or improve digestive function at the probiotic level. Vitamin C is always important for the immune system. In fact, that's probably vitamin C and vitamin A are the two most important immune vitamins, maybe 1,000 to 5,000 milligrams of vitamin C a day. And then also 20,000 international units of vitamin A a day. Zinc is the most important mineral for the immune system, 50 milligrams of zinc a day. And as I've said so many times, and we just said to Tony, zinc and vitamin A work together. Magnesium, also very important for the immune system, maybe 1,000 milligrams to 2,000 milligrams of magnesium a day. Look for the Osteomag. And then the OPC selenium, very antiviral. It's important for the immune system in general. It's important for glutathione. And so I'd be using maybe 200 to 400 micrograms of the OPC selenium. And then speaking of glutathione building strategies, especially glutamine. And if he's a weightlifter, he's an athlete, is he an athlete or doing any exercise or anything like that, David? David?
Well, that wouldn't, yeah.
Is he working out a lot or anything like that?
No, he works out maybe a couple days a week.
Okay, good. So he's not like a gym rat or anything like that. I was going to say, if he is a gym rat.